Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about multiplying fractions today, and I'm really just going to show you the process of doing it. For a further understanding, you should watch a video to explain that explains why we see what we see when we multiply by fractions. When we multiply proper or improper fractions, we can just multiply the numerators, then multiply the denominators, then reduce. Or we could reduce first and then multiply. If you're given a mixed number, change it into an improper fraction before you multiply. When we reduce first, that's called cross-canceling, and when we can, we'll use that method because it gives us smaller numbers. Things are easier to work with. In this first fraction problem, 3/5 times 7/8, we can't cancel anything. Cross-canceling, what we do is we look to see what's on the top and what's on the bottom and see if there's anything that we have in common. But there's nothing in common between 3 and 8 or 3 and 5. And there's nothing in common between 7 and 8 or 7 and 5. So we're just going to multiply straight across. 3 times 7 is 21. And 5 times 8 is 40. And that's it. If we had a common factor in here, we'd see it over here that there's a common factor. But since there weren't any to begin with, then there's not any in that. Anytime you multiply by 0, you get zero. Whether the zero comes first or the second, whether you're dealing with a whole number or a fraction, you always get zero. What about when you multiply by one? Anytime you multiply by one, you get the number itself. One is the multiplicative identity. So 6/11 times one is still 6/11. In other words, this number keeps its own identity. All right, what about this one, number 4, 2/5 times 10/13. Well, now here I can do some cross canceling because 5 goes into 10. 5 goes into itself one time and it goes into 10 two times. Is there anything else we can cancel? There's no common factors between 2 and 13 besides 1, which doesn't help. 2 and 13 are both prime numbers. So now I multiply across the top 2 times 2 and get 4, and across the bottom 1 times 13. And I get 13. What about the next one? Well, not as obvious if they have common factors. So if you multiply two things and you don't see the common factors, you could always simplify it at the end. But I can see 22 and 55 have a common factor of 11. 11 goes into 22 twice, and it goes into 55 five times. Now, you also might not see that 12 and 51 have a common factor, but they do, because if I add 1 and 2 together, I get 3, so 3 goes into 12. I know it goes in there 4 times. And if I add 5 and 1 together, I get 6, and 3 goes into 6, so 3 goes into 51 17 times. You can always check that with a calculator. You don't have to do that kind of stuff in your head. And then you're going to multiply straight across. 2 times 4 is 8, and 17 times 5 would be 85. And that would be the final answer. But let's go back to this problem, and I want to tell you this. You should be trying to do these fractions, or you should be doing these fractions on paper, but you should also maybe learn how to use your calculator to do fractions. Now, this calculator I'm using is a 36X Pro TI. If I went on to YouTube and Googled how do I do fractions on a TI 36X Pro, I would find a video for that. You can find a video for whatever calculator that you happen to be using. This button right here above the 7 is my fraction button. I just put in the numerator, then I hit that button, then I put in the denominator. So I'm going to do 22. I got to turn it on. I'm going to do 22 over 51, and then I'm going to arrow to the right using the silver button up here. Get out of that. And then I want to times that by 1255, 12 over 55. And then I'm going to arrow out of that. I probably don't have to arrow out of that at the end. Then hit enter, and that gives me 8 over 85. Pretty nice, huh? The other thing is you can always check to see if something can be simplified by putting in there, and I'll show you that in a minute. Okay, what about this one? Well, I'm going to cross cancel, and whatever you see, start there. I just happen to see 5 and 15 first. Maybe you'd see 7 and 21 first, but I'm going with 5 and 15. 5 goes into itself once, it goes into 15 three times, 7 goes into itself once and into 21 three times. 4 goes into itself once and into 8 twice. The only thing I have left on the top is a 2, but I have this 2 down here, so I can say that goes into itself once and once down there. On the top, 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 is 1. I definitely need to have a numerator. It's going to be 1. And on the bottom, 3 times 3 is 9 times 9 is 81, and that will be that answer. Okay, what about if you have whole numbers or mixed numbers? Well, if you have a mixed number, you need to find the improper form of that. If you have a whole number, you can find the improper form of that by putting a 1 under it. So we're just going to put a 1 under our 4 here and then multiply. I can cross cancel. I have 4 and 12 that can be canceled. 4 goes into itself once and it goes into 12 three times. If I multiply straight across, I get 11 over 3. Now I'm going to leave that as an improper fraction unless I'm asked to change it to a mixed number. Mixed number is not the end-all be-all. Sometimes you just want to leave it as an improper. Okay, what about here? 3 times 4 is 1. 3 times 4 is 28 plus 1 is 25. Sorry, just thinking out loud sometimes doesn't always sound right. Over 8. And 1 times 5 is 5, plus 2 is 7 over 5. Can I cross-cancel here? Yes, I can, because 5 goes into itself one time and into 25 five times, and multiplying straight across, I get 35 over 8. Another improper fraction that I'm going to leave. This one says find 3/4 of 4 and 4/5. The of means multiply. So 3/4, I'm going to take 4 and 4/5. I'm going to change that into an improper fraction in a second. Times 3/4. 4 times 5 is 20 plus 4 is 24. And then 3/4. I can cancel the 4. It goes into itself once. And it goes into 24 six times. And 6 times 3 is 18. 5 times 1 is 5, and I get 18/5, another improper fraction. What if I had a fraction and I wasn't sure if it could be reduced, and I just wanted to try that on my calculator? If you put into your calculator and use the fraction button, so let's say I had 255 over 81, and I didn't know if that could be reduced or not. I could just put it in and hit enter, and it's going to give me the reduced form of that, which would be 85 over 27. You can always check to see if your fraction is actually reduced. In our last example here, we're saying find the product of 5 and 2 and 5/9. A product means a multiplication as well. So you would take 5 over 1 because we want to multiply that as a fraction, and 2 times 9 is 18. Plus 5 is 23 over 9. And now we're going to cross-cancel, but there's nothing to cross-cancel here. Sometimes there isn't. So we're just going to multiply straight across. We're going to get 115 over 9. All right, that's it. Have a great day. See you next time.